yearly mass intentions. Thanksgiving for all the graces and blessings showered on Tathireddy Francis Reddy and family, offered by Tathireddy Chinnap Reddy and family. For the repose of the soul of Mrs. Monica Somasundaram, offered by Judy and Owen. For the departed souls of Paris and Saldana families and all friends, offered by Gladwin Paris. Thanksgiving Mass to Sacred Heart of Jesus for good health, peace, happiness and protection of family members throughout the year, offered by Mrs. Annie Dais. Thanksgiving Mass to Sacred Heart of Jesus for all the blessings on the family, offered by Ludraj, Swapna, Mary, Sarah. For God's grace and blessings throughout the year on M.B. Charles and all his family members, and as thanksgiving for all the blessings received and God's providence, offered by family members. Thanksgiving and for a better year, offered by Mrs. Maria de Souza. Healing of the family tree of Savio and Jyoti for spiritual, physical and emotional healing of all of family members, offered by Savio and Jyoti. For the repose of soul of Lynette Pinto, offered by Aloysius Pinto. For the repose of the soul of Marian Pinto, offered by Aloysius Pinto.
D. Rodriguez and V. De Souza thanks God for all the blessings received so far and requests for good health for all in their family, job security and promotion, and God's protection at all times, praying for all departed souls of the De Souza and Rodriguez family.
Light your patronage, O Holy Mother of God, despise not our petitions in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Grant us, your servants, we beseech you, O Lord God, to enjoy perpetual health of mind and body, that through the intercession of the Blessed Mary, our Virgin, we may be delivered from present sorrows and enjoy everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Hymn number 55 on page 15. Hymn number 55 on page 15.
God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide, hold me closely to His side, with love and strength for each new day.
Mass, let's pray for the following intentions. For the reposal soul of Mrs. Nevi Jacintal, Mass offered by family members. Mass offered through the intercession of Mary Help of Christians for the good health and the special intentions and for their education and business. Mass offered by Bandhanadam Antony Amrita and family members. For all the souls in purgatory and for all the special intentions of Mr. Krishna and the family members. It's a great joy for all of us to have Brother Sunil, who was a brother, now a deacon. Today only he got ordained. Let's give a thunderous applause and congratulate him. As we join this mass, all I request you all to pray for brother as he is fast approaching his ordination. All the things, all our prayers may be a blessing, and may his ordination become a blessing to all the people wherever he is going to serve. And I do offer this mass for all of you and for all your intentions. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
A normal person is chosen among the men to be a priest. He is ambassador to God and is a mediator to people. After we normally priest says, pray dear brothers and sisters that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. He is offering mass not for himself but for the sins and for the gifts of all the people. So a priest is chosen to be the another Melchizedek of old. Melchizedek is an extraordinary priest or a high priest who doesn't have a beginning or who doesn't have an end, which means he is a God. And the priest is a person of God, presence of God. He is celebrating Mass for you on behalf of all of you, and he is bringing God to you all. We are all fortunate to be the celebrants, co-celebrants during this Mass. Let us once again introspect and recollect the worthiness, the thing that we have missed. Many other times we just casually attend the Mass. If there are any moments and chances that we very negligently participated in the Mass, let us ask sorry for the things that we have, that we were negligible. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned. In my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my faults, to my most grievous faults.
Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, O Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, and forgive us our sins and bring us to an everlasting life.
Amen.
Please take hymn number 468A on page 118. Hymn number 468A on page 118.
Lord, have mercy on us.
the Gloria, please take page number 119, hymn 470C. Hymn number 470C on page 119.
Merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
With pleas for mercy, I will lead them back, among them the blind and the lame. First reading, a reading from the prophet Jeremiah, chapter 31, verses 7 to 9. Thus says the Lord, sing aloud with gladness for Jacob, and raise shouts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, O Lord, save your people, the remnant of Israel. Behold, I will bring them from the north country and gather them from the farthest parts of the earth. Among them, the blind and the lame, the pregnant woman and she who is in labor together, a great company, they shall return here. With weeping, they shall come, and with pleas for mercy, I will lead them back. I will make them walk by brooks of water, in a straight path in which they shall not stumble. For I am a father to Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please take hymn number 74 on page 20. Hymn number 74 on page 20.
Thank you.
deep within my being. Oh, the word of my Lord, you have filled my mind. Before I found you in the book, I knew you true and true. I choose you to be mine.
Forever, after the order of Melchizedek. Second reading, a reading from the letter to Hebrews, chapter 5, holy verses from 1 to 6. For every high priest chosen from among men is appointed to act on behalf of men in relation to God, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He can deal gently with ignorant and wayward, since he himself is beset with wickedness. Because of this, he is bound to offer sacrifice for his own sins, just as he does for those of the people. And no one takes his honor for himself, but only when called by God, just as Aaron was. So also, Christ did not exalt himself to be made a high priest, but was appointed by him who said to him, "You are my son, today I have begotten you." As he says also in another place, "You are a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Kindly rise for the gospel acclamation.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah, hallelujah. By the bread of Christ he stand. Every tongue, every tribe, every people, every land, giving glory, giving honor, giving praises to the Lamb of God.
Kindly repeat after me. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Our Savior Christ Jesus.
Our Savior Christ Jesus.
Abolished death.
Abolished death.
And brought life,
and brought life,
and immortality to light,
and immortality to light,
through the gospel,
through the gospel.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah, hallelujah, by the blood of Christ we stand. Every tongue, every tribe, every people, every land, giving glory, giving honor, giving praises to the Lamb of God.
from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mark chapter 10, verses 46 to 52. At that time, as Jesus was leaving Jericho with his disciples and a great crowd, Bartimaeus, a blind beggar, the son of Timaeus, was sitting by the roadside. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me." And many rebuked him, telling him to be silent. But he cried out all the more, "Son of David, have mercy on me." And Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." And they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart, get up, he is calling you." And throwing off his cloak, he sprang up and came to Jesus. And Jesus said to him, "What do you want me to do for you?" And the blind man said to him, "Rabbi, let me recover my sight." And Jesus said to him, "Go your way, your faith has made you well." And immediately he recovered his sight and followed him on the way.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The children who are supposed to enter into either boarding or a hostel, the moment when they get to know that they're day has come, the way they cry, the way they sorrow is, they express, it is inexplainable. The amount of, agony that they show as they fast approach to the boarding or a hostel, they keep on crying aloud. At least there may be some hope, thinking that their father or mother, they will take them back. But the same child, when the holiday is announced from the hostel or a boarding, amount of joy that child expresses beyond the words to explain. That, for that matter, all those who are in the hostels and boardings, they knew it very well. New bride, when she is about to leave their parents' house, the day, that few moments before departing her house, the amount of cry that she makes, it is all the onlookers, they keep on crying, because she was born and brought up in that same house almost for 18 years, 20 years or 25 years. Now she has to leave out all her household and everyone, and she has to go to her in-laws' house. The way she cries, even the others move into tears. The same bride, when she is coming back to her parents' house, amount of joy that she shows is beyond the words to explain. And we see meeting and parting are part and parcel of our life. Nowadays in the railway station, in the bus stand, especially in the airports, when our sons and daughters are living abroad for studies or whatever the job that they wanted to do, parents, they move into tears, especially onlookers. Few times I had a chance of dropping some of my friends at the airport. The way their parents were crying, I wanted to tell, okay, you better stop all your journey and come back. The very same son, when he is coming back, and the joy that their parents were explaining, or the joy that their parents were sharing with you, all the others saying that my son is coming back, my daughter is coming back, is beyond the words to explain. In the first reading of today, that's what we see. Isaiah, when the Israelite people are coming from the clutches of Pharaoh, their joy is so happy that he wanted to tell them, now shout aloud and sing aloud, thank the Lord, because you are no more under the clutches of Pharaoh. You are freed. The way you are coming back, you are not coming back by yourself. The Lord is leading you like a father and mother as they lead the toddler. When he is just begin to walk with his little steps, the father and mother, they hold their hands and make them to walk. They make sure that that child doesn't falter or fall down. Even if he falls down, immediately they will catch him and raise him up. That's the way the parents care about. Just ordinary people were able to care about you such an amount of love. if what about my way of leading you? It will be more than that. You believe in me and keep following me. I lead you to the place where you have, where you and your ancestors have been dreaming about. That is the promised land. From now on, you will not face any difficulties, neither your nightmares. All things are vanished. All the things will go away. Believe in me and follow me. Dear brothers and sisters, many other times, like Israelites, we too have gone astray. We too have faltered ourselves. Now let us rise and come back to the Lord. When we come back to the Lord without any comparison or without any compartmentalism, you are so, you are this and you are that one, he will not judge you. He will just embrace you and he will receive you. He is just waiting to receive all of us. In the gospel of today, we see how Jesus curing the blind man. Normally, blind men, they may be, we normally, earlier there is a word saying they are, it's a physically handicapped, but they are differently abled men. They are so capable in certain things. They are much capable than any other ordinary people who can, who are very normal and so on. I see when I went to Nalagonda a couple of years ago to attend one ordination, one man was playing that keyboard. He doesn't have eyes to see about. The way he was playing, I got mesmerized. Arre, it was such a blessed for your kind information. I tried my hands on the keyboard for almost 5-6 years, but I couldn't get through. In spite of having eyes and my hands fully equipped, but I couldn't make it through. Whereas that man who doesn't have eyes to see about where, what is a black key, what is a white key, but he was playing so mesmerizing way. Some of them are very blessed. Whereas this man, not like the other ordinary blind people. He has been waiting there for hours and days and months and years. He was waiting for somebody to come and raise him up. He was waiting for somebody to free him from his blindness. When he heard about that Jesus is coming, immediately he began to shout aloud. He didn't hear Jesus only on that spot. He had been hearing about Jesus, all his wonders, all his miracles, all his amazing things. That is the reason, the moment when he heard the name of Jesus, he wanted to reach up to Jesus and to tell all his sorrowful thing or whatever the thing that is undergoing, he wanted to share with the Jesus. So there were many people who were trying to avoid him, who were trying to stop him, who were trying to block him, but nobody could do that one. His voice was much more louder than the previous times, began to shout aloud, "Son of David, have mercy on me." The way he cried, Jesus immediately paid attention. Jesus was not the man who wanted to pay attention only to the bigger things or to the beautiful things or the people who are looking good, people who are really good at. He wanted to pay his attention to the minimal things. He wanted to show his attention to the unheard things or unnoticed people. He was one among them. Although there were a number of people who didn't notice, but Jesus paid attention to him. Immediately stopped. Although he was busy about his ministry, he wanted to give a break and to come and do something for him. That's the reason he asked, "What do you want me to do?" He said, "I want to see." He didn't ask for money or he didn't ask for any other gifts or other blessings. "I just wanted to see." Seeing the world or seeing the people is such a blessing, which many of us are blessed, but we are not able to see the things in ordinary way. I think sometime ago in YouTube, there was a video where a beggar, he was trying to ask for alms. He wrote one caption on the board, placard, saying that, "I'm a blind man, please do help me. I'm a blind man, please do help me." Very many passerbys were moving about, but nobody did. There was one girl who noticed that placard and she took a marker and she changed the caption saying that, "World is so beautiful, you are all able to see. I am not able to do that one. World is so beautiful, you are all able to see that one. I am not so." Immediately all those who were passing through, they began to drop in lots of alms to that blind man. World is such a beautiful creation which God has given to us. But very many other times, we are caught up with the minimal things. We are caught up with the minimal issues. We are so blinded with a few things, few things of our own household, few things of our own the society or the arena where you are staying about, or the gated community where you are living about, or the congregation where you are visiting. But a world is much bigger than this. A world is much beautiful than what we see. We need to open our spiritual eyes from the perspective, from the prism of God alone. Dear brothers and sisters, whereas this man, the moment when he received his vision, he left his cloak. As a beggar, he had only one bowl and one cloak to cover himself. He felt that there's no need for me to keep that one. He left behind that one. He began to follow Jesus Christ with a great joy and with a great happiness. We need not to have that cloak or neither the bowl to beg about. We have been blessed numerously. We have been given number of things even before we could ask. But are we being thankful to God? Are we grateful to God for all the things that we receive? Whereas this beggar, the moment when he received, he began to follow the Lord. We are following the Lord in spite of giving all the things. But are we grateful to the things? During this mass, let us ask for the grace. Lord, make me that I may not be a open-eyed blind man, so that maybe I may be a visionary who could see beauty in the hearts of the people, in the faces of the people, in the things that I come around in my day-to-day life. That I may not be a beggar, and that I may not be indifferent to the people and the things wherever I walk, wherever I move around. I may be a movable man, I may be a kind-hearted to the people who come to ask me for whatever the need that they are in need of. During this mass, let's ask for this grace. We may always be able to be a visionary, not only physically but also spiritually. Kindly rise. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under the Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again, ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father Almighty. From there he will come again to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of sins, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Be seated.
Please take hymn number 114 on page 31. Hymn number 114 on page 31.
All that I have, all that I have, I lay them down before you, O Lord. All my regrets, all my acclaims, the joy and the pain, I'm making them yours. Lord, I offer my life to you, everything I've been through, use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise to you, as a pleasing sacrifice.
Praise to you as a pleasing.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to you, O Majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed by above all to your glory, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hands.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just and duty our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that you, in your mercy, you sent us a Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you have loved in your Son. By whose obedience we have been restored to the gifts of yours, that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim.
Please take hymn number 468B on page 118. Hymn number 468B on page 118.
Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like dewfall, so that they may become for us the body, the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took the bread and, giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." The chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with the Francis our Pope and Paul Antony our Archbishop and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that be the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, together with Saint Teresa, Saint John Bosco, Saint Dominic Savio, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be merited to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Please take hymn number 468C on page 119. Hymn number 468C on page 119.
Lamb of God, O Jesus Christ, take away our sins, and have mercy on the soul, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, O Jesus Christ, take away.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please take hymn number 158 on page 42. Hymn number 158 on page 42.
He is my everything.
Some folks may say, who is this Jesus? You talk about every day. He is my Savior, and He sets me free. Listen.
Blood of Christ, water from the heart of Christ,
wash us,
passion of Christ,
strengthen us,
O good Jesus,
hear us,
within your wounds,
hide us,
never let us be
separated from you,
from the wicked enemy,
defend us,
at the hour of our death,
call us,
and bid us
come to you,
so that with your saints,
we may praise you forever and ever, amen.
O good and gentle Jesus,
we kneel before you.
We see and ponder your five wounds.
Our eyes behold what King David prophesied about you.
They have pierced my hands and my feet.
They have numbered all my bones.
Imprint on us
this image of yourself.
Fulfill the deep desires of our hearts.
Give us faith, hope and love,
repentance for our sins,
and strength to serve your people with respect and love.
O my good Jesus,
grant us these virtues,
which we desire so earnestly, for the good of our souls.
You who live and reign forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray for the intentions of our Pope, those who offered the Mass, and we who are present. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, and is now, and ever shall be, the world without end. Amen.
Continue to pray for Brother Sunil as he is one step closer to priesthood, that he may, as I in the introduction said, he may become a blessing to all the people wherever he is about to serve. And I do request you all to pray, wish for a short prayer for our youth members. Some of them are about to take part in a Pondicherry youth meeting, that they may have a safe journey and a pleasant experience, spiritual renewal in that youth meeting. And tomorrow, may your sacrament, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lies within them, that what we have now celebrated in signs, we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Please take hymn number 223 on page 59. Hymn number 223 on page 59.
Trusting my Lord as I walk alone. I just keep trusting my Lord, and He gives me a song. And the storm clouds dark in the sky, oh the heavenly tree. I just keep trusting my Lord, He will never free. He's a faithful friend.
He's a faithful friend.
Such a faithful friend.
Such a faithful friend.
I can count on him.
I can count on him.
Till the very end.
Till the very end.
I just keep trusting my Lord as I walk alone. I just keep trusting my Lord. Though the storm clouds darken the sky, oh the heavenly tree, I just keep trusting my Lord, even.